Welcome back to DonnaRon.com. Part of our main series of gaming.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We're at Inner Lake here in Linville, Indiana. We're in the Jeep Wrangler. It's a 2015 two-door. Just got it, and we're enjoying ourselves a little bit of...
Outdoors.
Outdoor off-roading.
Yeah.
Nothing wild, but... I like to, whenever I'm discussing video games, I like to come somewhere where I'm just clear of mind and,
get in touch with nature.
Yes.
Get in touch with nature,
it's such
absolutely.
A stereotype that all gamers do is, like, stay indoors and in their mom's basement. Look at us!
And it's a hurtful stereotype.
Oh, yeah.
We've been out of our mom's basement for at least 2-3 hours straight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We have different moms, too.
Yes.
Two different moms. What's kind of neat is we don't even have to play, like, Microsoft games, because we're playing one right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the car genre.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Like the Dirt 3. This is Dirt 3.
I've never tried that.
I haven't either. I think it's free on Steam.
It's
like
free?
I heard it was free, or maybe like a DLC was free or something.
No.
I'm not sure. But as you can see, this is rocky. Got our rumble packs in, huh?
Yeah, really.
Do you remember when the rumble pack came out? It came with Star Fox 64.
Yeah, it was such a thing. I remember like being shot by enemies and feeling the feedback, and I just remember that feeling so immersive.
Oh yeah, it was it was probably the first time I used the term immersive with a video game.
Really?
I didn't use that term, but I used the term that meant that.
Yeah.
Not sure I knew what immersive meant, but I also remember that on Ocarina of Time, you got that item where you could detect like secrets and your rumble pack would rumble.
What item was that?
It was like the Stone of Truth or something. I can't remember. It was really neat.
I must have not totally realized that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. It was a pretty neat thing.
We're like the only ones out on the trail today. We saw like two other people.
And they weren't really like extreming. They were on the main thoroughfare.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're off on... We don't have any like crazy body modifications, so we're just on the easy trail.
Yeah. Sundays are a good day for this.
Oh, yeah.
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 Most folks are probably doing it on Saturday, because most folks that are into the stuff, I don't want to stereotype, but they probably have church on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, like, most hardcore churches, they go, like, in the morning and in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So, like, you go out and you get dirty in your church clothes, I mean...
You just can't do that.
No, you can't do that. Very stereotypically Catholic in this area, so, like, you really don't want to do it.
Mm-hmm. No. No, not at all.
Ooh, big... Here we go.
We need like a second GoPro so that we can show the view out front.
Oh yeah. That would be tight. Have it like side by side.
Maybe one day.
Yeah, maybe one
Keep
day.
Keep it mashing that like button. We'll do that.
Yeah, like, subscribe, share.
So, you got any games that are coming up? I just got my pre-purchase done for Legacy of the Void and went through the prologue on that. I'm pumped. It came with, like, I can't remember, 3 or 4 missions that were epic. There was one running, and, like, the rest of them were base building ones, so they were fun. It looks like it's gonna... I haven't read a whole lot on it, but, like, Amon is in it. Spoiler for anybody who hasn't played the beta yet, so it'll... Like, Amon's making a return and whatnot, so that's going to be pretty fun. Zeratul's in, like, a mad rush to get everything done, more so than he was in Heart of the Swarm.
And, you know, what's kind of interesting about this is 2015, and we're just now playing Legacy of the Void. You know, like, this has been a 5-year span of releasing games that make one game.
I'm okay with it.
No, that's what I mean. It's kind of neat. Like, you know...
They're not rushing to pump it out.
Normally, you play it, you get a game, and boom! You know, you burn through it in, like, 20 hours or so. But this is kind of neat, and it's forced you to kind of...
Yeah.
It seems just when you start to not care about it.
Now, in the...
Another one comes out.
In that, you can, like, play Heart of the Swarm and Legacy in the Void in, like, a weekend. Like, in a
setting. True.
But, like, I guess the release dates of when they do an expansion is pretty out there.
Now, is anything happening in gameplay wise that you've seen so far in Legacy of the Void that you think is going to change anything on the competitive scene?
They already have it roped into the competitive scene.
Okay, okay.
Like all the people that got like actual beta keys, like, because I had the prologue, like, it's not like the beta.
They've been able to do it,
and like, I'm pretty sure there are some Legacy of the Void units, like, if you go into multiplayer right now and try and ladder, but I could totally be wrong. I haven't been in a competitive one for a little while. I've been so busy with work, but I want to. I'll get back into it as it comes forward,
as new releases come out and everything. Yeah,
well, as it gets close to the winter, like, I'll get more and more hyped about it.
Yeah,
and same thing happened with me with Wings of Liberty and Heart of the Swarm. All right,
ooh,
down here is like an insane turn, but it's really
fun. We gonna go that way?
We're gonna keep following this path. Yeah,
okay. Yeah,
no, I'm not going over the tree.
Oh, that would have been pretty cool. But no, it's kind of neat. Yeah, so I actually haven't played any of StarCraft 2.
Oh my god. Heart of the Swarm is probably the most metal. Yeah, but we were flexed.
So. Oh, true. It's the perfect time to talk about Heart of the Swarm.
Oh, yeah. No, like, Heart of the Swarm, it's such a metal game. Like, there's this one mission where you and like Sarah are like getting out of the research facility because it's being bombarded, and like you're on this platform and it's got all these like jet boosters around it as you're going up into orbit, and like there's metal playing in the background and like people are drop shipping in and there's planes flying everywhere and you got to shoot them down. I don't know how else to describe it other than
Rainer smoking his Lucky Strikes.
Yeah.
In the year whatever.
3000 yeah. Or whatever the fuck StarCraft takes place in. It's just, it's epic, and you need to play through it. I will say, if you don't know, like, the StarCraft, you have to kind of go through the anthology for anything really to make sense.
Yeah, you have to play through StarCraft. StarCraft 1 had an awesome story. Now, is Kerrigan a good guy?
And, well, it's kind of, you know how, like,
oh, we're in it, brother.
I don't know how to describe, she's not really good or bad. It's really just on your perception. Like, she's very, she was a good person, and then, like, she got betrayed.
Mm-hmm.
And, so that sent her on a vengeance streak. Mm-hmm. See, it's like these things. Like, I don't see the four-door Jeep getting through very easily.
Oh, me neither. Me neither.
So you gotta like twist your way around it.
Yeah.
Anyway, like, yeah, she got betrayed, so she really loves like James and will do anything for him.
Mm-hmm.
But like at the same time wants some closure in her life, so she wants to go after Minsk as well. So I don't know how she's gonna be spun off in Legacy of the Void or at the end of it, but she is back with the Zerg. Like, she's just, there's a whole lot of miscommunication between all parties involved, really.
It's like Three's Company. In space.
I guess so. I don't know.
You never watched Three's Company? It was a sitcom where like everyone would walk in on awkward situations or like mishear things.
Yeah, there's a lot of misunderstandings, especially when Kerrigan decides to go back to the Zerg in Heart of the Swarm.
Mm-hmm.
Like a total misunderstanding. Like, she pretty much thinks that Rainer's new buddy, I can't remember his name.
Tychus Finley.
No, not Tychus. He's like the captain that's on the battlecruiser.
Oh.
That they hijacked. Between him and Valerian Minsk.
Mm-hmm.
She thinks like they just stranded him, left them for dead.
Jumping to conclusions, that's just like a woman, you know?
But yeah, she needs, she has to go save Rainer in whatever way she can, and so she uses the Zerg
swarm
to do that.
To do that, yeah.
Oh, here's where it gets really fun, is down in here.
Oh man, that is cool. Yeah, so, how does a Jeep correlate to, like, you know, how is this, like, oh, Oculus. Oculus, do you think like they could ever, like, do you think technology is going to get to the point where like we could do this virtually and get that same sensation?
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
I can't imagine they don't have some like demo Oculus game. Racing or something.
I was listening to NPR the other day, and apparently they've got a movie like where you like are in, like they got a cartoon where like you're in the cartoon. Like, whoa. Woo. Like, yeah, it's very cyberpunk Blade Runner. That was cool.
Yeah,
that
we just like fun. Went through a couple of trees there. What are you playing, right? You just recently got back into Final Fantasy.
I recently resubbed to Final Fantasy 14, Realm Reborn. I didn't buy Heavensward yet because you need to be high enough level for that in-game content. You know.
I saw on because I was going through my Battle.net stuff. I saw the where you could buy for $60. You could just buy a level 90 character.
Oh yeah, and WoW. Yeah, they did that when Warlords of Draenor came out, which I think the story to Warlords of Draenor is really cool, but like, I don't know, man, WoW is just different, dude. It's just different, you know. And I know that's weird to say because 14 is basically just WoW for weebs, but so that's why it's probably so perfect for me. Oh, he is indoors.
Yeah, okay,
there he goes.
Yeah, so many people like reach for the.
I know, that's what my first instinct was, to get to the window.
There's so many bugs out right now. Oh, is he back? Just take your hat and kill him. Oh, he's totally dead. He's gotta be.
You gotta force it on him, you know?
Yeah, you gotta force death upon him.
Wouldn't it be hilarious if he started moving again? I know. And like, every time you close the window, he's just like, fuck you! You know what this reminds me of out here? Snake Eater.
Snake Eater?
Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, we're in the Russian jungle.
I've never played through a Metal Gear game.
You've never been all the way through one? Have you ever played one?
Well, I think like I have played one, but like I don't.
Like the first one?
I don't even know which one it was. It was one of Cody's games.
Cody had the first one, I know. Andy had the second one. He probably had Snake Eater. I can't remember. It's actually really kind of got this. That, like, I like stuff like that.
Dude, yeah.
Like, I wish we could show you guys what's going on
trail,
out here.
Well, like, they can see out the back.
Yeah,
Trail 1 is so nice. It interlake. Like, if you guys have, any off-road vehicle could do this. Like, a full-size truck might have some problems. But, yeah,
mother
he's back.
Fucker!
He went out.
Fuck that guy.
Or maybe it didn't go out, because we've been saying, yeah, he went out.
I know. Well, we thought he was dead.
Yeah.
We thought he was dead. Oh, here, there's a video game subject. Times when the game, when the game tricked you into feeling that you had done something only to, like, turn it back around on you. Metal Gear Solid at the end of one, the first time you play one, because now it's very trite and you just see it coming, but, like, first time you play one, man, you think for sure you got liquid like 3 or 4 times.
Oh yeah.
But no, to our point, like, I think what most people's perception of Indiana is that it's 100% cool. Like, they think of it like what we think of Iowa, people think of us.
Oh,
like Iowa's that it's just cornfield and flat. Yeah. And that's entirely not true about Indiana.
Oh no.
Up north, I think it might be more.
Well, as you get into central Indiana, it's very flat.
Yeah, but like, from Indianapolis on down, very wooded, very hilly.
It starts to get wooded and hilly, like, after Bloomington.
Yeah, like, right around there, because that's where my wife's from, is up around there, and that's when it starts getting into it. You've got a lot of woods. I mean, there is a lot of farms and corn, don't get me wrong, but there's still a lot of woods and stuff like that, and hills and trails like that. I mean, you can see just from our moving around, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I used to hate on TV shows when they would drive on, like, old TV shows when we were kids, and it would clearly be a videotape in the back window?
Hey, they had to do what they...
They had to do what they had to do.
Yeah.
I kind of liked it when they poked fun at it by having, like, a completely ridiculous video reel.
Or like he's just obviously swerving all over the place, but the wheel's not moving at all.
Or they don't watch the road at all. Like yeah. they're clearly having like a full conversation, and they do it so much to where it's literally them like winking at themselves.
Yeah,
it's very funny. But no, I'm not gonna get Heaven's Ward the first expansion until I get to end level content, because. Or if I even do, I usually get about level 23 or so and don't sub again. Because, I don't know about you, but like when I'm subbed to an MMO, you almost feel guilty.
Most difficult.
Most
difficult. Yeah, right.
But when you're subbed to an MMO, you almost feel guilty playing another game while that sub's active. You feel like you're wasting money. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like, especially WoW, because WoW's still expensive for a sub. In my opinion, for a game that's been out 10 fucking years.
Like, it's not that bad.
It's like, no, you can do it for about 13 a month, maybe. I still don't see how it hasn't gone free to play. I mean, there's so many microtransactions in it already.
Now, Tor is having an expansion here soon.
I thought it was a whole new game.
Maybe.
Maybe.
That one might be like... It might be like how the WoW expansions are.
It's still BioWare doing it, isn't it?
I think.
Yeah.
Have you watched the trailer of two brothers?
Yeah, where one is clearly becoming like Sith and the other is clearly becoming
dressed
like
in black and the other one's dressed in white.
Really heavy hand, very classic Star Wars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At first I saw it and I was like, holy crap, a new KOTOR. Mm-hmm. I was pumped.
Oh, I know. I thought it was going to be KOTOR 3.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which would have been badass.
Yeah. One day I bet they do it.
One day. They'll want to take advantage of that cash cow.
Yeah. Or somebody will remake 2.
And do it the way it was meant to be.
Yeah.
Yeah. 1 was so damn good though.
Oh, the original so great. KOTOR. I saw that was available on like Android now. You can get you can get it on the Google Play Store.
Oh yeah, that won't surprise me. I have it on Steam. I actually got it in 2 for free on Steam.
Oh, nice.
Yep, got a guy that just forwards keys to me. Not bad.
Not bad at all.
Nope. So yeah, we were kind of talking on the way out here about sort of the theme of this video and everything, and we were you know, we weren't really raised as, like, nerds, you and I. We didn't really grow up and, like, our dads weren't nerds at all.
We, like, manifested into it.
Yeah, like, our dads really, really weren't.
No, shoot. My dad was, like, the quarterback and, like, went on to be, like, an engineer.
My dad still has a record at Tell City High, I think.
Cool.
I think someone told me that, so whether it's true or not, I don't know. But, like, that's the kind of guy my dad was, you know, like, football player in the 70s.
Yeah.
So, and, you know, he liked hunting and fishing, like, you know, and another thing that differentiates us is we had, like, jock dads that we actually get along really well with.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, like, we weren't really raised that way. It was, but I was taught Final Fantasy VII in 1997 is really the first game where I didn't want to go outside anymore. I didn't want to play ball or anything. I just wanted to play that.
Yeah.
What was the first game for you that just, like, where, like, your friends came over, like, hey, dude, you want to go to the playground or something? You're like, nah, fuck it. Like, this game.
Oh, God. Pokemon was definitely one of them.
Yeah, Pokemon was a huge... But with Pokemon, you could go and, like, sit with your friends.
Yeah, Ogre Battle.
I was just thinking Ogre Battle 64.
Was a huge one for me. When I got a computer, it was Warcraft 3, even though I sucked at it. Like, I could only beat maybe, like, the prologue.
The hero system just fucked me up.
Oh,
the
yeah.
The hero units, yeah. I couldn't get past that.
I was really terrible at that.
That's like a legit stripper pit descent.
I know. That's awesome.
Like, I feel like we're going to a mine.
Yeah.
Which, that's another common landscape kind of thing here in Indiana. You see a ton of stripper pit in the part of Indiana we're in.
God, Pokemon was the first one I remember being, like, super crazy. Oh, my God. Now, Jedi Knight 2, Jedi Outcast.
Oh my God, yeah.
I know it was like a linear game, but oh my God, I enjoyed the piss out of that.
And that's another thing about our generation is we could look back on extremely linear games and appreciate them in the way that younger nerds can't. For instance, one game that just blew my mind was Metal Gear Solid, and I just went on V the other day and they hate it. Like, they hate the first one.
Interesting.
Well, the, whoever, obviously V is not one single entity with a mind, but
yeah,
like most of the people posting on that particular thread hated it. And it kind of shocked me. But when you think about it, like, I could see where a younger kid would play that and be like, this is fucking garbage.
Mm.
But like me, for instance, I thought, I still look back on it and think it's extremely innovative. And because at the time, I mean, it blew our mind.
Yeah.
Like, I was just on TV the other day, I saw a commercial where apparently they're making a movie about NWA. Like, the rap group.
That's... Well, okay.
It's coming out, like, next week. Like, it's soon. And I was thinking about it, and, like, you know, like, today we kind of just take advantage of, you know, I mean, we kind of just take for granted that, you know, a rapper is going to rap about, like, street life and stuff. But, like,
yeah,
when they did it, that was fucking shocking. That was, like, yeah, the late 80s. Like, yeah, no one was, you know, doing stuff like that. So it's kind of that same, I'm not going to expound on hip-hop as though I know a lot about it, but that's kind of the what I feel about it. But
no, I do remember.
This is fucking gorgeous.
Oh, yeah. It's very, very pretty.
Yeah.
Now, I do remember, whenever I got a Nintendo 64, Mario 64 being, like, what I just wasted time on.
And I remember that game just, and I think that game still holds up. Yeah. You know, kids today still play that, and it's great. Just like the original Super Mario Brothers, but, like,
yeah,
I remember.
See over there?
Oh, yeah, I can definitely see over there.
The water, the lake.
Yeah, that looks like a, that's like a Dungeons & Dragons thing. Like, you would come out of the dungeon right here with all the rocky area, and you'd look over, and the DM would be like, okay, here's the experience points for a successful quest.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I think if we get up. Like, I actually don't know how that trail would be, because it's not marked.
Incredibly insane.
Like, but
that looks
like
a grade like we did earlier.
Yeah. Like, I think we could do it, but I'll try it another day. I'm, like, slow. As I get out here and do stuff, I start to see, okay, now what parts would I want to put on the Jeep? And most of it's like, well, okay, yeah, never mind. It says it's got the body modification symbol on it.
Oh, okay. Actually, it's kind of neat because the trails out here are marked with symbols, and the symbols actually correlate to, like, easiest, hard, and it's kind of like, you know.
Yeah, it's got, there's the hills where you can take a stock vehicle through. Mm-hmm. And they tell you short wheelbase, so not a full-size truck. Maybe like a Tacoma. But,
that wasn't that bad at all.
They, the blue is for body modifications, and you need at least a 2 or 3 inch lift, mm-hmm, with 33 inch tires.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the most difficult, where it says, expect, body damage. It's insane.
Also, one thing we should probably address is why we're out here in a Jeep with the top on and everything. And, like, when you fling mud in a Jeep, like, you fling some mud.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
It goes everywhere.
Like, yeah. This thing doesn't have, it barely has 9,000 miles on it. Like, I'm not going to rip it up completely just yet.
And that's probably where my pasty nerdness comes through the most. While I don't mind getting muddy, I would avoid it.
Oh, yeah.
If it comes, you know, like... I'm not excited. Like, getting muddy isn't part of the fun for me. It's sometimes an unfortunate byproduct.
This, though, when you get this thing muddy, it's so easy to just clean. Just spray it off with a hose.
Yeah, a hose that you bought at Lowe's for $7, right? It wasn't that much at all.
Oh, that was a spray nozzle.
Oh, yeah, not the hose
the
itself,
hose?
The nozzle.
I have no idea where I got that hose at.
I don't know that I've ever seen anyone actually buy a hose. Most of them just show. I didn't buy mine.
When I got that house.
Oh, yeah.
I had to go buy a hose.
But, I wonder if people our generation like, because I don't...
Like, we should be able to get a really good view of it. Like, if you come out over here.
Take
a short break for a second.
Yeah, we'll take a short break and we'll be right back.
Welcome back. Took a quick break. Took in the views for a second.
Yeah, it's, where were we?
I think we were talking about, games that really, really took us from that point of we're just being kids and playing day to day to...
Yeah.
This is something that's changing changing, life changing.
When you first got into games and you were like reading magazines and shit, because we're old enough to where we remember actual like
Nintendo old Power?
Ass like magazines. Yeah, Nintendo Power, EGM was a huge one back then. What was the first game that you were just so goddamn hyped for? And like every magazine that you saw something in it for, you just like ate it up.
Command and Conquer Generals.
I remember when that was coming out. God, that really was huge for real-time strategy players.
Me and Ryan wanted Rise of Nations like super bad.
They just released like an HD version of that, didn't they?
Yeah.
Was it any good?
It didn't have the same feel like it does when I was back then, that I had for it back then. But like,
do you think that's just because it aged poorly, or?
Kind of. I played that before like I got super into StarCraft.
Mm-hmm.
So after I discovered StarCraft, it was hard to go back to anything.
I remember when StarCraft came out, it was so hard to play Warcraft 2 again. Like, it was really? So hard. Because, well, with StarCraft, each race was different.
Yeah.
Like, with Warcraft, they weren't really.
Oh, and I guess that's important to note. Like, I know Rise of Nations came out after StarCraft, but uncovering of games was not necessarily in the particular order of their release.
Mine as well.
That was like just a testament to our time because we're out in the country.
Yeah,
and
we didn't really
limited internet exposure.
You had to go to town. You lived in a town, but you had to go to another one to buy good games.
Oh, that was so. Yeah, it was a small town.
Yeah.
Like, granted, Tell City is bigger than a lot of places around here, but I mean, it's still a town of like 6,000 people.
Yeah, and I grew up in like a smaller town than that even, so you had to go to Evansville if you wanted anything.
And you were closer to Evansville.
I was closer to Evansville, but I had two parents that like, they just didn't go that often because my dad worked in town. Yeah. He never had to leave, and mom didn't work growing up. But anyway, you finally get to go, and I remember the game I was hypest for was Final Fantasy VIII, because as I said, 7 was what kind of got me into that, like, gamer, like, where you just, what you did was play video games.
Yeah.
So 8, I was so, and to this day, I will defend that motherfucker. Everyone hates it, I'll defend it, I'll argue till I'm blue in the face.
On Linus Tech Tips, or it's his counterpart that does videos as well, loves 8 instead of 7.
Really? That's awesome! I didn't know that. That's
I forget
awesome.
What video it is, but like he's very open about it.
But like I think 8 was a fantastic game, and now I don't know if it's just because I can't let go of all that hype I felt as a kid looking forward to it. But I loved 8. I thought it was a fantastic
game. I imagine there was a ton of hype after 7.
Yeah, I mean, my God, this was the game to end all games. And then I'm a huge fan of 9 as well.
Cody, I remember the only thing Cody ever played on it was the card game though.
On 9 or 8. Yeah, because 8 and 9 both had a card game. And
he was, like, extremely addicted to that.
Yeah, I remember I was really... But when I started a game on nowadays, I can't fucking get into the card game.
Interesting.
I can't do it.
Oh, you know what? I remember wasting a whole lot of time. Now, I got a GameCube, and I had Rogue Squadron. That was a fun game on GameCube.
Oh, Rogue Squadron was so good.
But I burnt a ton of hours on the Sonic Adventure.
Sonic Adventure 2. Yeah, with the Chow.
Yeah, I burned a ton of time on that.
The Chow or why me and my brother begged for a GameCube.
Really?
Yep, we wanted a GameCube so bad because of the Chow. And what was funny was my brother was still in like fourth grade or something, but I was like a freshman.
That was one of the first games I legitimately noticed music perfectly correlating what was going on with the screen.
Rolling around at the speed of sound.
Yeah.
Got places to go. I remember on something awful.
The jungle level with the drum solo thing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that got me.
And people shit on Sonic games, and maybe, I know Pro Jared did a video where he, like, shat all over that game, but
it's
I still think it's a great game.
It's very much a skater drinking your Mountain Dew type of game, mentality.
A very I legitimately still like Blink-182 kind of game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I could see that. But, like, I won't remember, I just love that game. Actually, that's the only game I have bought 3 times. I bought it 3 different times. I bought it for the GameCube. I bought it for PSN when it first came out for PS2. And I bought it on Steam. The Steam sale was absurd, though. It was, like, 99 cents for it and the Battle DLC.
Oh, crazy.
So, but at the same time, it was actually a Humble Bundle sale, because Humble Bundle summer sale was so much better than Steam's this year. It was outrageously better. Whoa.
Let these guys pass.
Yeah, because stopping is a much bigger issue for them.
Yeah.
We got some motocross gentlemen.
Thanks.
Yep. Yeah, the dad waved at us, but the kid was, like, not confident enough to take his hands off the bars.
Oh, yeah.
I guess. This would be a great confidence booster for, like, motocross people.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. But,
Don and I did legitimately, see one person being, called off, though.
Oh, no shit?
You can get fucked up out here. You can get fucked up.
Yeah.
If you're not careful. Like, we're just easing through this. I mean, I haven't gone over, like, 7-8 miles an hour pretty much through most of the trip.
I think I need to start a new game on Final Fantasy VIII. I think I need to play through it again. I have the Steam version.
Oh, yeah.
But, actually, PC, let's talk a little bit about the transition. When was the first time that you were like, you know what, I'm just done keeping up on consoles. I think I'm just going to do this PC thing.
After GameCube?
I think, because, you know, like, after GameCube, I kind of fell
like
out of it.
I got, like, midway through GameCube, and that was it. But now you're entering different points coincidentally in my life too.
Yeah
like I'm going off to college,
yeah,
and stuff. And when did we come out? What was that?
Well, we came out in like 2006. Were going into college
right,
yeah,
as I was coming out of high school.
Yeah,
which, okay, at that time there were just a couple things I was interested in: moving out, mm-hmm, of Tell City, starting my career, my girlfriend at the time, and my car.
Yes.
So, yeah.
You were very, like, 50s movie guy.
Now, video games would play an interesting part in this because I was super confused. Like, I barely passed high school. Mm-hmm. Like, pretty much on a good graces of, like, two teachers that I passed high school. And I didn't know, like, okay, Army or try school. And I tried college for a year.
Mm-hmm.
And I was okay enough with it, and I got into computer programming a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So,
oh damn,
this is how we came in.
Oh, I remember this. Yeah.
Yeah, we just got through that whole trail, so I did two trails, and now this leads back out to Oakville.
Cool. Yeah, I kind of fell out of it after. And I remember I bought an Xbox 360 in 2006.
Yeah.
I bought one off a friend.
Where I was going with that, I got super into WoW.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I remember you telling me that.
Oh, yeah. I played a lot of WoW during that first year of college.
Your account's still active, ain't it?
I
mean, not active like you're paying on it, but it's still there.
Yeah, like you haven't gotten rid of it. Sure. Yeah, like my first character is still in it. Mm-hmm.
You stole Cody's account, didn't you?
He transferred it to me.
Oh. But yeah, I remember I actually didn't go to college. I went to a trade school.
Vincennes? Like,
well, Vincennes was after I was married.
Oh.
Like, after high school, I fucked off for 2 years, two straight years.
Oh.
I worked in town, but until 2007, I fucked off. And I remember I bought a 360 and I played a lot of it. And then after I graduated, like, I have met the woman who is now my wife, and I really didn't play video games a whole lot.
I could not get on the 360. Just couldn't. There was nothing I liked about it.
Yeah.
I didn't like the games.
Uh-huh.
I was not a Call of Duty person. I hated the controller. Still don't like the controller.
Everyone says it's the greatest controller of all time. I don't see it. I don't like it.
No. I don't even see how they say it. I mean, tons of people say GameCube controller is.
I'm one of those people. Perfect.
I just wasn't. I hate Smash on it.
You hate Smash on a GameCube controller?
I hate it.
That's crazy.
I hate it.
It's the perfect control, but
I will whip more butt with the gamepad than I do
the Wii U gamepad?
Yeah.
I've noticed you do that too, and that's crazy because no one else is really all that great.
And then I don't care what anybody says, I love the Nintendo 64 controller.
I do too. I love the 64 controller.
But that could be because I just played a shit ton.
Nostalgia glasses, yeah.
Well, not nostalgia,
You're used to muscle memory.
Yeah,
yeah.
Practice at it. Like, I could whoop butt on Smash on there. And the GameCube, I had it a long time. I played a lot of it. It just wasn't my favorite. Now, comfort level, yes, it's very smooth. It contours to your hand. Mm-hmm. I get it and everything. The double joystick thing, I hate. I hate that.
I mean, the double joystick's where the world is now.
I know.
Like, there will never be another controller that don't have
that. I know. And
the gamepad has two.
It does.
Yeah.
It does. But how, like, the C button being down there with it, I just hate it. It's obvious they tried to play off of PlayStation's, and
yeah,
I just couldn't do it.
No, actually, a close second to the GameCube controller for me is the PlayStation 3. Love the DualShock 3.
Yeah. They barely changed, like, how that controller is.
Well, the 4 has changed it dramatically.
Oh, is it?
The DualShock 4 changed quite a bit.
Okay.
Actually, with my 5-year-old, I've noticed that the PlayStation controller is actually kind of really neat for him, because when he was real little, you wouldn't have to say hit A, B, or C. You would tell him shapes.
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed that. But, no, it was, and I just had this dry spell when I was engaged and dating Ashley. I just had this dry spell where I didn't really play video games. And then we didn't buy PlayStation 3 until 2011. And there was all these games I missed out on. And I just ate them up, like, real quick.
Mm, yeah.
But then the 4 and the Xbox One were announced. And I was just like, I was an adult. You really need a computer in your house anyway. So PC gaming just made sense. And now that, like, I've gotten used to, like, Humble Bundle and Steam and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I just can't imagine going back to paying $60 for a new game every single time.
Can't imagine. It depends. I don't think that... I think, shoot, I can't remember. I think, Legacy of the Void was $49.99. I think.
The last game I bought brand new at launch, the day it came out, and I paid full price for it, and it was $49.99, was Dragon Ball Xenoverse.
Hmm.
Thankfully, it turned out okay, because I was taking a risk. It was just tax time. I had $50 to blow, so whatever. Well, I guess you never really have money to blow, but you know what I mean.
If there was a KOTAR 3, screw it. $50, $60, whatever it was.
Yeah, I would probably do the same thing. Now, I would go to, like, Green Man or something and check.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, I would check before. Yeah. But you know what? You don't pay to buy PC games, like, at opening now. Because, like, that Batman game, like, it launched and everything, and it was so broken, they actually, like, just took it off and said they were never going to fix it.
Interesting.
They refunded people and stuff, I think, but, like...
Can you imagine if they did that with Legacy of the Void?
Oh, my God.
That'd be nuts.
Oh, my God.
That's not nuts. Nice stuff, though.
Yeah. They canceled their new MMO.
The Blizzard. StarCraft Universe?
I thought it was Titan. It was like Project Titan or something.
Oh, never mind. Okay.
This has been a while since they did that.
Yeah.
But
they're
making too much money off WoW. They're still like, what, 9 million subscribers?
I bet. If there's a StarCraft universe, I bet it ties into WoW somehow.
Yeah. Like where you would maybe like where the Draenei are from.
Maybe you'd go there. No. Or I just mean like you can enter that world. Like, you can enter the world. Like, they might not have any stories or anything interlaced.
Yeah.
But, like, you can go visit Ironforge as, like, a marine or something like that.
That would be badass.
I could see that. I could totally see that.
Cool.
So, how'd you like Interlake?
Oh, I loved it. That was really cool. That was a really neat experience.
Awesome. All right. Well, we're going to sign off for now, but stay tuned. We'll have more of these videos. Let us know how you like them.
Main series of gaming.